Hello, my name is Hiroki Sayama. I'm the associate professor in the Department of System Science and Industrial Engineering at the Thomas J. Watson School of Engineering Applied Science. I'm also the graduate program director of the System Science PhD and Master's program here at Watson School. My research area is generally called as Complex System Science and Engineering, which embraces many different kinds of systems that are made of many different components that are interacting with each other to create very interesting behaviors. The original research area was actually the pure computer science. Specifically, it's called the parallel processing. Now it's called the distributed computation, which is the research area where you have lots of computing units working together to simulate or calculate very complex computational tasks. And when I was working on that task as a master's student, I get kind of interested in the interaction between computing units. When you put many different units together, their behavior starts to, looking kind of weird, even though you designed everything to the bottom of the detail. So that is called emergent properties. When you have interacting components working together, sometimes their interaction actually causes the really non-trivial outcome. So that is one of the roots why I get interested in this research area. So that made me drop out of the mainstream of computer science. Now I'm working on a very interdisciplinary research area. Anything and everything that can be considered as a complex system is part of my research agenda. Even though we are part of the engineering school, I would say the system science program is probably the farthest away from the core engineering part. We can study things that are almost remotely related to engineering concepts, such as social media, and propagating diseases in the human social systems, as long as we can formulate their behaviors and structures by using some mathematical computational terms, we can study and potentially predict and manipulate the behavior of those systems. So that's the what's most challenging about system science. So therefore, I'd like to see the students who are intellectually really, really risk-taking, and those people who are not comfortable sitting in the single discipline, those are the perfect students for our program.